Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are going to study chapter Plant Growth and Development. In that, we'll be studying seed dormancy. When I say seed dormancy, it means how a plant from a small seedling or a seed, it will grow into full-fledged tree. We are going to study the process, how plants grow basically. Seed dormancy. The process by which a dormant embryo of a seed resumes active growth or forms a seedling or a young plant that is capable for its independent existence. This is what seed dormancy is basically. Now, what do you mean by active growth? What do you mean by seedling? When you give nutrients to a particular seed, what happens is there is a small growth that takes place into the seed, and this small growth is nothing but radical. And from that radical, roots grow, shoot grow. When I say shoot, it means the stem grow. So students, this is the way how plant grow. Now plant growth is divided into four different stages. The first stage is imbibition, that is uptake of water. Whenever you plant a seed in your life, you put a seed into soil, you water that seed. And why do you water that seed? Because seeds are in their dormant stage, or you can say they are in enclosed stage. So when they uptake water, their seed coat ruptures or the embryo becomes little bit viable. After you have put in water, the next step would be respiration, that is metabolism and anabolism of the seed. The same way you respire, similarly plants also do respiration. The third step, mobilization of reserve food materials. Whenever you are hungry, you all want food. Similarly, when a young plant is growing, it needs food to grow, and that food is used or present inside its cotyledon. When I say cotyledon, it means the covering. So gibberellic acids produce certain hydrolytic compounds. When I say hydrolytic, it means breaking down compounds which break down certain compounds. Example of this could be lipases, amylases, and these compounds are responsible for uptake of food from the cotyledon or the food covering. And the last step, growth of the embryo. After you have given food to the plant, you have given water to the plant, and you have provided soil to the plant with appropriate conditions, what happens that the plant grows. It starts its cell division with the help of meristematic tissues. So this is how plants actually grow. The definition of seed dormancy is the process by which a dormant seed, when I say dormant, it means a seed which is not in its viable form. It's not living basically. Embryo of a seed resumes active growth and forms a seedling or a young plant capable of its independent existence is basically growth of the plant. Now factors which are responsible for the growth of the plants are The steps responsible for the growth of the plant are, first, imbibation. Imbibation is nothing but you water the plants or you put water to the seed. The second step is respiration. In respiration, it means the whole process as you, we humans do it. The uptake of oxygen, the removal of carbon dioxide, the breaking of glucose, all this is respiration. The third step, while growing, we all need food. Similarly, plants, they need to use foods. Now, gibberellic acid that is produced in plants produce hydrolytic enzymes. When I say hydrolytic enzymes, it means enzymes which helps in breakdown of sugar or help in the formation of sugar. And the hydrolytic enzymes produced are proteases that helps to use protein, amylases that helps to use starch. All these enzymes are responsible for uptake of glucose in food. Now, the reserve food material is used from the endosperm. When I say endosperm, it means the seed coat or the outer covering of the plant. And the last step, growth of the embryo. After plants have received sunlight, they have received nutrients from the soil, you have added water, and after the whole growth period, the plant actually grows. So students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied actually how different stages like imbibation, respiration, mobilization of food material, and growth of the embryo compromises the growth of the plant. I hope you all are clear about various stages of seed dormancy. Thank you.